One of the greatest things about the Hackr.io platform is the user-submitted tutorial and learning resource section. So where users like you can submit learning resources you think others would get value from, you can all upvote and let each other know what to use to learn a new skill. And today I'm going to help you learn more about that. I'm going to dive into it with a particular emphasis on C++. So here I am on the Hackr.io platform. I am logged in and I'm in the tutorial section looking at C++ tutorials and courses. And as you can see, there are lots of things you can do on this page. I would highly encourage you to visit it and explore yourself. But I'm going to take an emphasis and a focus today on one of the top voted resources by the users on Hackr.io. And that is this one here, the LearnCPP or the LearnCPP.com website. This is a free website, text-based, online course-style website that is dedicated to helping you to learn C++. And you can see it is the top voted resource by the users on Hackr.io with so many visits, over 90,000 views. Essentially, this is one of the best resources as chosen by our community and audience at Hackr.io to learn C++. So here I am at learncpp.com. And if you're not really familiar, C++ is one of the most powerful programming languages out there. It's also notorious for its steep learning curve. I think that's something that a lot of people do know about C++. If they don't know how to code in it, they've heard that it's hard to code in. And maybe if you think about it compared to something like Python or JavaScript, it might seem intimidating. But learncpp.com is one of these fantastic resources that's completely free, text-based, and aims to make learning C++ available to everyone anywhere. But ultimately, how does it stack up against some paid options or other books or other video-based courses? Well, let's have a closer look at what's here. And like I say, I must stress, this is completely free. And I think it is incredibly detailed and excellently well thought out resource. And whilst there are no videos, I think if you just take the time, you'll actually find this is an excellent place to start learning C++. So it's dedicated obviously just for that language. Been around since 07 and offers a structured curriculum, covering everything from the basics to advanced topics like move semantics, smart pointers, and even template metaprogramming. Now, maybe you don't know what any of that means yet, and that's fine. That's the whole point of this website. You take your time working through it, and you will learn those concepts. And the best part, again, is completely free. There are no signups, no subscriptions, no paywalls. Yes, as you can see, there are some ads. Of course, they've got to keep the lights on. That's fine. But this is an amazing resource. If you don't mind that, I think it is well worth considering if you want to learn C++. I mean, it is a little bit like an old school college curriculum. It feels like if you're at university or college and you've got a course in C++, this is kind of like that. And I'm quite familiar with that. I spent some time at university. I get it. Some people might prefer video-based content, but I'd actually encourage them to consider checking this out first because it is free. It's really well designed. It's really well thought out. There's an active comment section and the author's often checking as well and replying to comments. So it doesn't feel like you're completely on your own. So again, there's a lot to talk about, but let's get into some of the pros. So comprehensive, I would say, is the biggest one. And up-to-date content with 28 chapters and lots of updates in 2024 and even in 2025. It ensures that the content reflects the latest C++ standards, including C++ 23. So the topics are arranged logically, naturally, you'd expect that, starting with basic like variables and loops, before progressing to advanced features like polymorphism and exception handling and other things you need to learn. Also, I think it's accessible for all skill levels, whether you're a complete beginner or you're brushing up on modern C++ features. This is something here for you, I would say. It lets us start with simple concepts, like writing your first program, and gradually build towards more complex topics like move constructors and smart pointers. But the idea is that it's gradual, it builds up, and it is accessible for everyone. You've just got to take your time and work through the different steps. And I also like the fact that it focuses on best practices. The tutorials within here emphasize not just how to write C++, but how to write it well. I love that. I think that's a fantastic idea. Learning how to write in a language and learning how to write it properly is so important. If you do it right the first time, you haven't got to unlearn anything. And this is a really great strategy, in my opinion. You'll also find tips on avoiding command pitfalls, how to write clean code, and how to understand nuanced topics like undefined behavior and type safety. What's great is that whilst it's text-based, it's hands-on learning. I'm a big proponent of hands-on learning. This means that each chapter includes examples, quizzes, and practice problems. This allows you to immediately apply what you've learned. So the debugging-focused chapters teach essential problem-solving techniques, making this resource, I think, really practical and interactive. I think, essentially, if you take your time and you're serious about learning C++, maybe you want to become a game developer. Maybe you've learned that you need C++ to write AAA games. Maybe you have. Well, this is a great place to start. Yeah, you could dive in and learn about game engines right away, but it doesn't hurt to learn the basics of C++, and this is a great place to start if you want to do something like that. Now, let's talk about some of what you might call cons. I don't know if I necessarily think they're cons, but there's some things to bear in mind. Of course, it's a text-only format. And nowadays, I think a lot of us are used to video. Video courses, whether it's on YouTube, Udemy, Coursera, wherever you're getting your online learning content from, we're all very used to that idea. And this is text only, so it might seem a bit strange, maybe even seems a bit old compared to that, but I think it's concise in detail, and it might lack some of the visual engagement of video tutorials and interactive coding platforms. And that might be a challenge if you really prefer that dynamic approach. With over 1,000 lessons, it really might feel overwhelming if you're just starting out. But I think beginners might find it you really useful to pair this with a simpler introduction or even a small guided video course. So if you're feeling like, yeah, this is a big undertaking, I'm a bit concerned. Okay, you don't have to use this alone. You could use this alongside a video course. That's fine. Also, I'd recommend maybe even using AI. You know, I think in this point in time, AI is everywhere. It's unavoidable. And I think using AI, whether it's ChatGPT or GitHub Copilot or whatever you want to use, I think using AI as your personal tutor, your personal instructor to add extra help when you need it is a great method. You could be getting through this and you might want some clarification and AI may be able to help with that. But of course, you know, it's all online. It's in the browser. There's no PDF, so you've got to stay within the browser to access it. That's fine as well. I don't think that's a big issue. But ultimately, if you are weighing up your choices and you're thinking about pros and cons, those are some things to bear in mind. But I think overall, the pros most definitely outweigh anything that you might consider a con. Something else that you can find is if you look at the user comment, look at the feedback from users. They love the depth and clarity of all the information in this. Users are often saying it's better than books they paid for, and they are just so blown away by how much effort Alex, the author, has put into this content. And he even responds to comments, keeping the content fresh and interactive. That is a big thing, and it shouldn't be overlooked. I think it's incredible. And the fact that it's free is just absolutely amazing. So there you go. I think if you are genuinely serious about learning C++, whatever the purpose may be, maybe you want to write the next Windows operating system, maybe you want to learn to write games. I don't know what you want to do with it, but if you are serious about C++ and you don't mind the text-based format, I think learncpp.com is a goldmine of knowledge. It's genuinely so rich. It's unbelievable that it's free. It's crazy. And I'm really impressed that the Hackr.io community found this and upvoted it, because I think it is genuinely incredible. So have you tried it out? Have you used learncpp.com before? Are you familiar with it? Have you got anything to say about what you think about this resource or any alternatives maybe we should be considering? But whatever it is, let us know. And I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.